Hi everyone, welcome to the Docker architecture. So Docker is actually known for code, build and deploy. We are doing the development with the help of Docker. We are building it and we are deploying it. So everything, the complete development pipeline is there on the Docker. Okay, so Docker is a platform for developers and sysadmins to develop, deploy and run application with the containers. So container is something which is acting like a virtual machine, which will be running your application. This is having the minimal Linux kernel, okay? So the use of Linux containers to deploy application is called containerization. And containerization orchestrations are happening with the help of Kubernetes and other tools. But first, what is container? Container is a minimal Linux kernel which is able to run your application, run your JavaScript code, Node.js code, Python code, Java code, right? Containerizations are not new, but they're used for easily deploying applications or developing application. Okay, we already have compared the VM virtual machines which are creating on hypervisors or containers we are creating on host operating system on top of Docker daemon. Okay, now Docker engine, what is this? So Docker engine is actually a daemon process which is running on your host operating system, which is allowing you to create new Docker containers. Okay, so Docker daemon process. So the thing is, I have the CLI interface. From CLI interface, I am just doing triggering this command. So what actually happening? I am actually triggering the REST API. So this is a Docker daemon. Docker daemon is already working here because Docker is running. Docker daemon is running on this host operating system. And from CLI, actually I am triggering some commands. Okay, so from CLI, like you are doing Docker images, Docker ps minus a, Docker rm containers, Docker rm I image, all these commands you are triggering from client, which is a Docker CLI. So Docker CLI is actually talking with the help of REST APIs to your Docker daemon process. So there is a REST interface is lying there. So from this command line, you are actually triggering a command, REST command, to the Docker daemon process. And Docker daemon is taking the appropriate action. Okay, so there are different Docker commands we have seen till now. So those different commands are executing the REST APIs and then sending the instructions to the Docker daemon process. Then it is taking the appropriate action, like deleting the image, creating the container, stopping the container, restarting the container, or building the Docker file and creating the containers and all. Okay, so Docker CLI, we are doing what we are managing the images, managing the containers, managing the network, managing the volumes. This is what happening from this command line interface. Okay, now this is the complete flow which I was talking about, connecting the dots. Okay, so first you need to understand few basic commands. This is the diagram. If you understand this diagram, you know the Docker. Okay, so this is the Docker registry. I will put this is a Docker hub, so it's like a GitHub sitting out there on the website, Docker hub, which is making you to pull the Docker images. Okay, before understanding everything, what is a Docker container? Docker container is nothing but a minimal Linux kernel. And if you are installing Nginx there, then I will say this is Nginx container. If you are installing Redis, I will say it's a Redis container. If you install Node.js, okay, I will say this is the Node.js container. Okay, but base image will always be some Linux distributions, most probably Ubuntu. On top of it, we will install these different softwares, Redis, Node.js, RabbitMQ, blah blah. Okay, so first thing will happen, Docker pull, because I'm new to Docker. I wanted to create a Java container where I can deploy my application Java. Okay, so I will do Docker pull Java. So what it will check, Docker pull Java, it will check, okay, do I have that particular image? Image is nothing but an instruction. It will check, okay, do I have that image available on my local system? No, then okay, go to the Docker registry. This is a GitHub of Docker. From there, I will pull the Java image. Okay, so I will pull and I will keep that image here. Okay, simple. Then when I run that, so I pull that image, Docker pull hello world. Okay, then I'm doing Docker run hello world. Docker pull hello world, what it will see, it will check, do I have that image locally? I will use that. Otherwise, I will pull it from Docker Hub, Docker registry, and I put that in the images list. Now, I do docker run hello world. What it will do? It will run that image and will create a container. Okay, so docker pull. What it is doing? It is actually trying to pull that hello world image from Docker Hub. So you can see latest pulling, it is actually pulling the latest one from Docker Hub. And this is the digest file, and image is already up to date because we were already having this hello world image. I can just try to docker rmi. So docker, first you need to stop the container because I'm trying to delete the image. Docker ps minus a docker stop container. So this is I think already stopped. There are two containers out there. Okay, docker rm. I'm trying to remove all the containers. Now docker images, I have two images with the hello world, docker rmi. You can pass the image id. So let's see, where is hello world? This one, right? Do I have any other image named hello world? No, right? So we are good. Now if I try to execute docker pull hello world, what it will do? It will pull the image, latest image from Docker Hub. So from here we are starting. It is actually pulling the all the layers, and now it is the latest one we pulled. Now if I do docker run, so I got the image, that's it. Now I will run this image, and from where I pulled this image, this was not available locally. I pulled it from the Docker Hub registry, and then I'm doing docker run hello world. So now it is running it, right? Using the default tag latest, and it is running that particular container. So from docker image, now it is a container, but this container has exited because there is nothing to execute. Like similarly, you can just do docker pull ubuntu. What it will give, it will pull the ubuntu image for you if that is not already there. Okay, then we will run this particular ubuntu image, and you can also enter into that container after pulling that. Earlier we tried to enter inside the container of hello world, so I think the command was not correct. So you can see it downloaded it. Now what I'm doing, docker run it iterative interactive mode. This is the image name and bash console I wanted to enter. So you can see I entered inside the docker container, which is my minimal kernel, right? Here you can run all the commands. Right, so I have apt get update, and you want to install Node.js, Redis, Kubernetes, whatever you wanted to do, you will be able to do it here. Okay, so this is the running container right now. If you just talk about docker ps minus a, so this is how we are creating the container. So first I did docker pull that ubuntu image is here. When I do docker run, okay, this image become container. We'll talk about docker build later whenever we start talking about docker files, the plain docker file which we will write from ourselves. Right now we are getting the docker image from docker hub docker registry, but we can also frame our own docker image by docker file. Okay, so we talked about docker client, docker host, and docker repository. So docker client is this, from CLI we are running the command. Docker host is the docker host is your docker daemon process, and docker registry is sitting somewhere outside on some cloud from where we are pulling the images. Okay, so simply docker versions, docker info, all these commands you can run. Like currently if I run, so I'm inside the container, you can exit from here. It will give you the list of images, containers up and running. So two containers are running, total 11 containers are there, total 40 images I have. I have a lot of memory being used by docker. Okay, so Docker commands, we will talk about these in the next video.